Stubbornness. Have you ever had anything in your life that's stubborn? Because I have, and one of them is getting my dogs to listen to me. They always push me around and disregard what I have to say. I learned several ways to solve that problem. One of them is dog training. To train my dog, I started off by getting them physically interacting with me, rewarding them, teaching them simple commands. But this takes time, patience, and a lot of practice to do. So to start off with, you want to get interacting with them. You can do this by playing with their paws, any little movement to get them moving with you. You can even tap the table and see if they follow you. If they can do this, that's really good for a first step, because that means they're going to be more willing to do tricks for you. But it may still need a lot of practice, and that's okay, because before we get to learning tricks, we need to learn how to properly reward them. To reward my dog, I either give them a lot of pets, which they really like. They show this by wagging their tail like crazy. Or I speak in a really happy voice, because by doing that, they know they're doing a good thing. When I speak in a lower voice, they think they're in trouble. So I make sure to speak in a really high-pitched voice. But my dog's absolute favorite treat is animal crackers in that exact container, not just a little plastic bag. They don't like that. They prefer them in a bear shape. I don't know, it's really specific, but they really like it. So what works, works. So anytime they do something good, give them one of these positive reinforcements so they know it's a good thing. Now that we know how to reward them, let's learn how to teach them a trick. To start off with the teach a dog a trick, I like to show them the command and give them the word. For an example, I want to use sit. I give them the command of sit and say sit. But when you say it, you want to have a really strong voice. Because if you're not confident in what you're saying, they're not going to believe you. They're not going to be as willing to listen to you. So be really strong and know what you're saying. So you're going to give them the command, and then you're going to help them do it so they don't just have the command and have no idea what they're doing. So with the command of lay, I like to put my hand up and pull it down. But since they don't know what they're doing yet, I like to put their body down into a lay position, and I repeat that several times until it's a fluid motion. It's not a fluid motion yet. That's okay. You can always go back to repeating the steps over and over again until you see fit that your dog is ready to move on. I hope that by slowing down and practicing these steps, your dog is better trained. I also hope that you now know how to get your dog moving with you in fun little games you can play together. Not to mention the different ways you can reward your dog after a long day of work. Plus, your dog can do basic commands just by the movement of your hand. That is a really amazing thing. So by taking time to practice, you can accomplish so much in life. Just remember that next time you go to do something.